Welcome back to Steven's Sausage Roll. Last time we made it to World 4, finally. And, as you might expect, World 4 is harder than World 3. Let's see. We've got this nice color filter over everything. We've already seen that tablet, but I think the most productive thing to do might actually be to just seek out the tablet in World 4. It seems reasonable to assume that there is one. But, maybe it'll just give me the philosophical, change of heart that I need in order to, work at these things. Or, maybe it'll be just nice to look at. But, we'll get ourselves a nice little preview of what we're gonna be, working with here. More ladders, more or less as I expected. Alright, what have we here? Some fences? Some gargoyle statues? Not sure. But that's going to be a precarious place for me to get my extra sausage from. Okay. Unexpectedly dour, but, I mean, that's what wisdom is. It's kind of thinking about things you'd rather not think about. I mean, there's more to it than that, of course. I'm oversimplifying. But, yeah. Oh, yeah. There's the gate over there. Remember the gate? Good times. Fond memories. Let's maybe not start at this end of the island. I think I'm just gonna leave, Wretch's retreat aside for later. That one seems a little bit hard. Maybe I'll independently rediscover the, techniques I need for later. That's, ominous looking. For sure. Is this a ladder? No, that's a ladder. Okay, so this is where we take our, you know, this is where we take our vertical sausage and we turn it into a horizontal sausage and put it over here, of course. That's definitely a theme of this world, for sure. At least it's been a small theme, anyway. This one seems simple enough. Let's be scared of this one. Okay. Sludge. Is that what this is? This is a, these are just logs, I guess? Logs with mushrooms? Hard for me to tell. Could just be walls with a whole bunch of leaves stuck to them, maybe. Well, we have our friend the Overhang here, whose, presence and absence I've been, carefully noting. So that's one way to get a sausage off your head, for sure. It would seem, once again, our goal is to take a, vertical sausage and turn it horizontal. Turn it 90 degrees. Well, this time it should be easy, right? With the, new tool that I have, carefully noted here. Because now it's no problem if it's, in my head in perfect 0-degree alignment. Because I can fix that. Yeah, like so. In fact, that's actually it. Now we're done. Because now I've created a horizontal sausage, I just push it off the cliff, and we've got two horizontal sausages, and life is good. Yeah. It's always nice when you, you know, you try a tactic in a puzzle for so long, and then it doesn't work, and you've conclusively proven that it doesn't work. And then you go to another puzzle, and that's the very same tactic that you've been trying for a really long time is actually what solves this new one and not the other one. And, it makes you feel like you, like all that time you spent developing that new tactic was worthwhile, that it was time well spent. So, I can be reasonably certain that, other puzzles are not going to be so kind with their, terrain. But, it was nice to get good use out of an old log for once. A single sausage, you say? Utterly terrifying. We'll see what we can do, though. Wait, where do we start? We start up here. Okay, well, we need to be able to get back up here, then. That's an issue. It's an issue which, once again, we might be able to solve by turning this horizontal. What kind of tree is this? It's just your standard, normal, vertical tree. At least I think it's a tree. You know, these things can be get kind of abstract, you know. That's alright, though. And I should note that we've got the pair of ladders this time instead of just the single ladder. Potentially of use. Alright, where did that start? Up here. Well, let's do the thing that we expect to have to do. Let's see if we can get this in alignment now. The direction of stabbing is going to be kind of important here. I think it's I think we're going to stab it from the left. Okay, no good. But maybe from this angle? I want to be able to do the full 180, like, full rotation here, but I don't have quite enough room. Because if I try and face south and that happens, if I do this, then I still can't go down the ladder. All I can do is go back here. If I try and move upward to get more space, then it just deposits it right there, and that's no good. So close, but no cigar. Okay, that's how you do it then. You just carry it straight forward. This was not possible in other puzzles because trees like this were not in direct alignment with the ladder like this. They were always kind of like diagonally aligned. But now that that's possible, that's a different way of getting it on top of my head. So now all I have to do is deposit that there and then push it off the cliff and presto. Horizontal sausage. Now, what do you do with the horizontal sausage? I'm pretty sure you don't put it right there, because that's how you have to get back. So instead, we'll log roll it over here, and work with it from this ladder instead. Of course. And of course, we'll deposit it on that single grill over there. No, that's not what you do. You push that over, and then we'll cook the other side of it. Then we move this back up, and we'll slide this into place. So it's done, and then we can walk back up to the upper side. Piece by piece. That's how you figure these things out. You just gotta work backwards. I mean, you don't always work backwards, but sometimes you do that and it works out for you. So use this puzzle in order to get down. Nice having two side-by-side like that. How do we get down there, I wonder? That is down, right? That looks down to me. No, it's in alignment with the other ones. Yeah. It's, oh, well, there's still a sausage there that's in the way. Yeah. This is, kind of confusing. But, oh well. This looks like kind of a headache, so I guess I might as well get it out of the way now, right? Crunchy leaves. Got a big ol', leaf pile, I guess. I guess this is what this is. It's really, really compact if I can walk on top of it like normal ground. And, of course, there's a sausage all the way over there. How am I gonna get over there? Because it is a truism that, the only way to work with sausages is to either push them directly with me or my fork, or to indirectly, have a sausage do some of my work for me. So, for example, I could do something like this. But I can rapidly see a problem where we're gonna create log jams pretty soon. So I think it would be better if I could somehow get a vertical sausage up top here, and then drop it off. And I foresee this ladder up here being incredibly handy. So I don't think that's our first step. I don't think we want an uncooked raw sausage being down there to be our bridge. I think we want to drop this on the west side, roll it over, and then have a cooked sausage be our bridge. I think that's going to be better for us. We still need to stab this in an enterprising location, though. Because this is not the correct stab. This is the wrong stab. This, however... Yeah, this is sneaky. This is the correct one. We should be able... Yeah, we... Thankfully, with the help of that second ladder, I'll be able to get that, other sausage back, but I figured something like this had to work. It had to. That's not in alignment. This is in alignment. Interestingly, I could lose my fork at this juncture if I wanted to. I probably don't. That seems unproductive. I'll keep an eye out for that, though. Like, I know I can do it, so... It may be a thing I have to do later. Actually, I have to be able to move that anyway, so... And I was gonna be on top of it anyhow, so... Yeah, log rolling is the correct way of doing that, not shoving that off the cliff. Okay, we'll do that. Alright. Well... We can already see another problem. Which is that, in order to do that again... I have to... Well, no, wait, I've still got a horizontal sausage, so, yeah, I can just do that again, right? Yeah, that's fine. Of course, the horizontal one is gonna have to... Well, no, it won't have to turn vertical, necessarily. If I can find a good spot to drop it off at, I won't have to do that. Whoops. No, so that does have to be one tile downwards. Is okay. We will fix. Okay. So then we have to dismount over here, but that's still fine. But then I'm thinking what we do is we have to take the horizontal sausage with us. Hold on. That's not a good place for it. Before we log roll off, before we put that in an inconvenient spot, let me, free that horizontal sausage and put it in a better spot. Somewhere we can more easily work with it, because I do need to have my fork able to go into that spot in order to get down here. So we'll just leave that out there. Alright, I look forward to seeing how I am wrong. Okay, so my theory is put the horizontal sausage on the left here, dump it here, log roll it once, and then everything is cooked and I can just get down. Show me the error of my ways, puzzle. Show me how I am wrong. If I do a downward stab, I should be able to use the ladder facing the other way in order to get this work job done, right? No, I think I'm all set, right? Yeah, I mean, I still have to go over here instead of the other way, but... Yeah, alright. It's, just have to be a little bit creative. And, just do the minimum possible work that might work, that might solve the puzzle. And, it might work. Sometimes you will actually be able to do the things that you want to do. It's crazy, I know, but you just come up with these things, and every now and then they actually, work properly. How am I doing on time? Pretty good. Pretty good, actually. Alright. Let's move on to this one, then. Oh, the Gator Paddock. Better watch out there. Never know when you're gonna find that gator. So I guess this is a swamp world, then? Yeah, I could believe that. It's not very usual. You don't really see... You don't really see this kind of, like, sunset swamp, usually. But I guess you could make it work. I am immediately concerned about that little protrusion at the top there. As well as this extremely bizarre set of ladders. Is my goal, in fact, to create a vertical sausage? Is that what I am being asked to do here? Horizontal seems unlikely. I don't know what I would do with horizontal, because if it stayed horizontal, what I'd have to do is I'd have to drop it off. I'd have to, like, basically get it on the, get it on one of the walls and then kind of roll it off and, like, land it. Like, I'd have to land it on both grills at once instead of kind of pushing it over from the west. That's why you can't just win the puzzle immediately. So it's either that or turning it vertical, in which case you, well, you still can't get it through this narrow gap now, can you? So you'd still have to kind of work with the sides of this somehow. How far over can my fork reach from up here? Not super far. Like, the best I could do is, like, drop something here. And then if I were properly oriented, I could maybe, like, take a vertical sausage that was right here and shove it forward like that. But that still wouldn't, necessarily get anything done. What I could do instead is take a vertical sausage and put it on top of my head. Which wouldn't work because if it were on top of my head, then it'd get deposited up here or here. But if it were instead, if there were a horizontal sausage on top of my head, then I could turn it this way, turn it that way. And then I could get it to be 90 degrees if I wanted. I could put it on top of my fork. And then what would this do? It would just drop it vertically right onto there. And if I do strafing moves, like, all my strafing moves will still, they will go horizontally into the sausage area, but they still won't be able to, like, I'll just immediately be forced left. I can see some cases in which that could help, though. But, yeah, I'm just trying to figure out what I want to do, because if I don't even know what I want to do, then there's, like, no point in messing around, because there's a lot of things in which I can do with that ladder structure. I am sure of it. But I want to have a clear picture of what's going to actually solve the puzzle before I just go and do crazy things. So, but that's currently seems to be the first step, is, like, get it on top of my head. Could be either just in full alignment, that 0-degree alignment that I love to hate, or the 180-degree alignment. Either of them would work. I think with the help of this overhang, I can create almost whatever offset I want. So that's what that's there for, really. So I think that's probably enough direction to get started with. That's probably enough. We've got both of our ladders on the ground level are, horizontal ladders. I guess I'm just going to call them horizontal ladders because they're ladders that you use horizontally, and they're ladders that you can take, well, you use vertical stabs on horizontal sausages in order to carry up. Now, the question is still, how do I proceed from here, though? Because, of course, there's a premium on the unhooking spots. There's also a premium on the ways I can stab downwards, which, of course, if something is hard to do, it's probably part of the solution. So, how can I get that done at some point? The only obvious places I see to do that are against the structure itself, which you can't really do. There's not enough space. You can create such a stab in here, but then you can't take it out. Can't take it outwards. So, I guess that means we're starting with a vertical stab. Or log rolling. Log rolling is also a possibility, but it doesn't, I mean, what would I do with that? There's nowhere to go. Yeah, like, there's, like, if I start here, then the only places I can go are here by clogging up the ladder, which, doesn't seem immediately helpful. I mean, I can do it, sure, but it's not immediately helpful. I can see one way in which a downward stab would help, though. Because if I already had a downward stab, like let's say that I already had this stab and I was stabbed into the left side of it, then what I would do is I would just climb up this ladder, I'd deposit this over here, and I'd unstab, and then I'd already have it on top of the ladder for me. And I think I could then descend this whole jungle gym over here and keep it on top of my head. But that presupposes that I already have the downstab. But once I do get it, then I'm basically set. Okay, well, what else can I do? If I had a second sausage, it'd be a lot easier to create places to brace against. But, I don't have that luxury. Is this perhaps the titular alligator of the paddock? Is this single sausage actually my looming threat, my looming nemesis? Well, it is if I just, command, my hero to just drown himself, but let's not do that. Let's do more productive things. We haven't really gotten anything done yet, so we'll just do that. Well, hold the phone. I said that I can't stab inside the paddock, but why not just use the gate as, like, a place to stab? That's, not something you'll immediately think of, but it is a thing you can do nonetheless. That's one of those things that you just have to outright notice, for sure. Then what? Well, then I can do that. Yeah, and then I just go down the ladder, and it's fine. Now, I still need to, turn that into, like, an aligned, aligned one of these instead of an unaligned one of these, but I'm sure I can figure that out somehow. So let's see. So, in order to do that, I'd have to... either already have it on my head and figure out how to turn it the other way, which I think I can do that actually with the help of the because I already had it like 90 degrees on my head down here, right? Yeah, I had it down here, so I'm pretty sure with the help of this structure, if I do things just right, I should be able to do a turn that is good for me. Well, not quite like that. The problem is, ironically, my fork, actually, but, yeah, okay, there we go. Got it nice and flattened. So, what I did is I just pressed myself up against this wall. This whole wall is flat, as you can see here. And I just turned, upwards. So, normally that would turn the, sausage to my left, but it can't because of the terrain. And now I've finally gotten what I wanted. A situation which is bad in a lot of other puzzles, but is good here. Now let us enter the paddock and, be terrified by the consequences which it foresees for us. What do I do here now? I can get it on top of my fork like that. I can do all sorts of manipulations I want, but I still need to be able to actually drop this in a good spot. So ideally, what I want to do is figure out a way to drop the sausage onto a pair of grills. Or I could drop it off my head while it's facing, like, upwards in here. That would also work. In fact, actually, that's enough, right? Because now that it's facing this way, I just push it onto the grills and I'm done. Alright, that works. Like I said, it's all about prerequisites, and now that the sausage is actually on top of my head inside there, now I could just make it vertical, and skip the gate, and we're all set. Cool. I've got time. We can keep going, at least for a little while. Making good progress. You know, maybe I'm just getting my head wrapped around this kind of stuff, faster, because like I said earlier, I think it's just because I'm just fumbling around with it, practicing it for so long, that now that this sort of thing is relevant, now I, have a better idea of what to do. Still not sure about Wretch's retreat yet, though. No helpful overhang in that one. But, it's okay. We'll get to it. We'll get that figured out. Good time. How am I doing on progress, actually, come to think of it? This place seems a little bit smaller than World 3. If I already gotten most of the things done on it already, that can't be right, can it? Got that solved, got that solved. That's a puzzle for later. Got the Gator Paddock solved, got the leaves solved. Yeah, I solved like 5 puzzles already, haven't I? But there were a lot in World 3, weren't there? There were like more like 10. But I think this is my last puzzle. Okay, well, back to work, I suppose. So what have we learned? We've learned that overhangs are super useful and they are your best friends, which I already thought of earlier, but we've confirmed that now. No such luck this time. We've learned that a single ladder gives you certain manipulation opportunities, but is also not as convenient as having 2 ladders. But instead of phrasing things in terms of what we don't have that we wish we had, let's phrase things in terms of what we do know. We do know that a ladder will allow us to transport sausages that are in the correct alignment up there. So either a vertical sausage like this, which is no problem. As long as you stab it horizontally, then you're all set and you can do whatever you want. Or if you stab a horizontal sausage from either the ends, which is a less desirable stab because it's hard, you can't unstab without assistance, but you can still get certain amounts of work done. I have also noticed that the exit is an eastward-facing stab, so it is theoretically possible that we could stab this sausage facing eastwards, keep it in our fork the entire puzzle, and not lose that way. Because once we're done, we would go over here and we would finish. Now, I don't know to what extent this will help, but it is still worth thinking about. Now, I know we did a lot of playing around with this earlier. I think the ultimate, the conclusion we came to is that it was harmless to fry the upper half of this what now while we can, but we still did not want to, we did not yet want to fry the horizontal one yet, because it was entirely possible we might want to pass it over this grill at some point for manipulation purposes, rather than for, just for cooking purposes. And I think I do have to be holding the upper sausage when I do those kinds of stabs, because otherwise it's, otherwise it winds up, being, well, inconvenient, really. Alright, so that's how we want to get that done. We want to rotate this sausage 90 degrees, or 180 degrees. 180 would also be fine in this particular context. So, not to too closely repeat the things we have already done, let us at least do the things that seem helpful. Putting this on top of the island is helpful. It's harmless, we can get this off the island very easily. Does not result in a permanent, it's what's the opposite of an improvement? Like a disprovement? No, that's not right either. Just like, it doesn't worsen our position, I guess you could say. So we've created this structure. We have noted that because it is a 2-sausage structure, I don't have a helpful 3rd sausage around. I can't just immediately transfer this onto my head at a 90-degree angle from this position. If there's a way to put it onto my head at a 180-degree angle, I have not yet figured that out either. But it is entirely possible that there is a way, and I just haven't figured it out yet. In some way or another, the terrain is going to be key to this puzzle, as it always has for all the other ones. But here it's going to be more fundamentally, like, it's going to be part of the puzzle in a way that's more subtle than I'm immediately latching on to with my prior puzzle experience. I have not yet found a way to cook a sausage that is already on top of my head. That seems... I'm just going to go ahead and declare that you can't do that. Yeah, that seems safe. Although, that could be relevant in another puzzle, just not this one. I can put a sausage on top of my fork with moves like this, and that allows me to do all kinds of strafing moves like this, but right now, because I'm not stabbed into a sausage, well, for one, I don't want to do that, I think. But the minute I try and turn, I'm going to drop it. And I'm going to drop it specifically, because I've already gotten this out of the way and off this column, I'm going to drop it on the ground, which puts us right back to where we started. Now, with regards to this tree, once this is on this tree, I don't see anything productive to be done about it, because I can't get the horizontal sausage on top of my head. I can stab it, I can take it off the up the ladder, but once I stab it, I can't get it out of my fork, and once it's in my fork, I can't put it on top of my head. So, there doesn't seem to be any particularly helpful way of getting the horizontal sausage up a level, and because I can't do that, once the vertical sausage is resting over here, I'm not getting it back. That all seems fair. If I try and lift the vertical sausage while it's on top of the horizontal sausage, then that also limits the kinds of moves that I can do. Interestingly, if I do this, if there's a particular way in which I could roll this and not lose it, that would result in me being able to stab this and carry the vertical sausage on the east side of it without losing it, because then I would be able to back up and, well, still keep carrying that around. I don't know what use that would be, because I would not be able to rotate, and I wouldn't be able to get that off my, fork. The best I could do would be to unhook it here, but I could maybe see that helping. And more importantly, it would make this particular eastern bit over here relevant. I have not failed to notice that, I'm just trying to figure out how that's helpful. So, if I could, say, for example, let's back up to the point where this was on the island. If I could push that downwards a little bit, then I could create that scenario I was just talking about. So, we'll go ahead and do that. Back up a little bit. Back it up. Okay, there we go. Close enough. We'll put this on this side, and we'll move the horizontal sausage over here. In fact, we'll even just go ahead and just put it in that position, ready to be stabbed immediately. Yeah, sure. And what side do I want to stab it on? It's not immediately apparent which way it would be relevant right now, but I guess we'll do it this way. Alright. I'm pretty sure I've been here before, but I think this is an easier way of doing it than the way I already tried. Alright, and there's not really much else I can do with this other than just kind of fool around. Even doing that doesn't really do anything, because it's still just a combination of a backwards move and a forwards move, so there's nothing special about that. Nothing inherently special. I could, if I do this specifically, no wait, of course that's still going to slide it over, of course. I was thinking that would wind up on top of my, my fork, but no, of course that's not going to happen. If I do that sort of move, it's just going to roll off the top. If I do it the other way, though, which is, well, by process of symmetry, it's still like this. If I do it like that... hold on a minute. What if I abuse the tree? Because I'm thinking is, like, here's my new thought. When I do this kind of downwards move, I push that downwards, but then my fork returns to this position. It doesn't go down, it goes back east. So I get the benefit of a downwards push, but my fork returns to the eastward position. I feel like my intuition is, like, blaring, like, five alarms. It's DEFCON 1 right now. Like, like, that has to be what's relevant right now. My brain is saying, hey, pay attention. This is what's necessary. And I am feeling super confident. I've got the emotions on high alert. I'm feeling strong and confident about this one, folks. Let's set up a situation where that's relevant. That would involve getting the sausage on the west side of this, which I can do. That's not hard. In fact, I can even... Alright, I think what I want to do is that. That move. Then, I'll go up onto the island, and I will push the vertical sausage over to the west half. Alright. Okay. Let's find out what this does for me. Well, it does exactly what I thought it would do. It means I'm carrying this, on my fork now. I thought I would be able to do something special with that afterwards, but it turns out that I can't. It's a nice thought. I could rotate this in any of the other directions and off of any of the corners. But I don't see any interesting features in alignment with that. I was hoping that, like, I'd just be able to walk forward or backwards and get that on top of my head that way, and then life would be good. But I'm not immediately seeing any benefit to this. Alright. Feeling a little bit more miffed now. But that's okay. That's part of the puzzle experience. That's life for you. Alright, and of course there's nothing special about that kind of move. Alright, so let's not immediately dismiss this, though. We've had various ways of, putting the sausage, like, on our fork, but most of them were, well, yeah, actually we haven't yet done something like this yet. All the other ways we've done that have involved it being on top of our heads and being in the 0-degree formation. But I feel like this is it. It's just that there's nothing to bump that against. If I were aligned with a ladder, would that help somehow? I don't feel like it would, but it would be possible. Would it be possible? Well, hold on. Could I do a similar maneuver with me standing to the east of the tree and doing something that, like, pries that out from underneath the, like, if I had that on the... Yeah, I'm seeing a new formation. I can get that if I shove this over here, I can do that. Yeah, that's doable. So I'm going to put that on that row. Shove this sausage over here. Okay, but how am I gonna get back down? Good question. Now I'm good, because now I can just shove that down. But no, I wanted that to be on the east side. No. Now, how am I gonna get that on the east side without creating problems? Well, we'll just, I'm just gonna go ahead and restart, but that's okay. It's not hard to do from the start. This is definitely a conceptual puzzle rather than any kind of executional puzzle, for sure. Absolutely. I saw that from day one. Except we're still on day one, so That statement loses some of its strength, but I still am super sure about that. Okay, in fact, why not, don't even, unstab it over here. Unstab it on top of the island. Well, okay, I have to do that, though. It's okay, though. Wait, I didn't actually cook that part yet. Right. Yeah, that's better. Okay, stab the upper half of it and put it on the island. And we're gonna put this on the east half of the horizontal sausage. That's what we're trying to do in order to create the new formation that we will transport over to this single tile obstacle. And that's what it's trying to teach us, the value of a single tile obstacle in creating a new manipulation move with regards to a two-tall sausage stack, which is the most fundamental of three-dimensional sausage stacks. That is what we're learning here. And this move will be very helpful in puzzles to come. Alright, this is what I'm looking for, I think. Not quite. It was what I was looking for, but it was the wrong thing. But that's okay. I'm used to that. Because, yeah, this was already resting on the east side of that, so that's not super helpful. If instead I move this over like so, yeah, then how else does that work? Yeah, so far all we found is a way to put the vertical sausage on top of our fork, but is there any other way which we can use the tree to our benefit with this little half rotation? I'm not sure yet. But just because I'm not sure doesn't mean that there isn't a way. Alright, so let's review. This is essentially the only move that I'm considering here. There's rotations and reflections of it, but that's pretty much the only way we've seen here. I'm gonna go not real far back. I'm not gonna need to go real far back here, I think. Just like a little far. If I put this on the west side of the island, I should be able to reconfigure the option that I want here. And, I mean, in fact, it's okay, even, it's fine, I'll drop it, I'll put it back up, it's fine. No need to get frustrated, this is just, it's just normal manipulation. Yeah, nice and fast when you know what you're looking for. Right, the way I wanted to do that was to... put that up there, and then... yeah, and then push the sausage upwards. And then carry it down, I think. Right, because I want to move that westwards, but then also have the sausage be down. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, so then I can slide that away from the cliff on here, then do this backwards move, and then just slide it into position over here. Right? But then I wanted it on the west side and not the east side. But that was possible, right? Yeah, that was possible. Like so. There we go. And that was a position I had before. So interestingly, yeah, that's the reflection of that. So I could do it in this position on the southeast corner instead of the northeast corner. And like I said, there's like 8 different ways I could do this. I don't know which way is relevant yet. But there doesn't seem to be anything particularly interesting in alignment here yet. Now, come to think of it, there's no particular reason necessarily why I would need to do that on that particular tree. Maybe there's a different obstacle I could use to much the same effect. The island seems a little bit iffy, if only because, it restricts my own movement, and also the movement of my sausages. And it's also an inconvenient place to deposit things. But I still haven't figured out how I go from sausage on top of fork to sausage on top of head. That's, like, the key feature here that I'm missing out on. I don't know, there's just no features that are up this high that would push it here, so that's not the answer then. There has to be something else that, I can do. Yeah, like if I slide the horizontal sausage west in this position, then I can get it onto my, head. But, like, if it is to the north of me, then doing that, would necessarily involve, getting the fork to my, north. Like, there's no westward pushing moves I could make. Well, let me just put this over on the, northwest corner where it would be more or less, the same thing. Except that it's... Yeah, funnily enough, it's harder to transport this whole structure south than it is north. North is easy, south is hard. So, let's not put it that far south, I guess. Yeah, if I transport that whole this whole structure, before I made the adjustment, over here, then this ought to be a rotation of the same thing. Except that it would be, yeah, there's something I'm just not quite visualizing correctly about this whole thing. Yeah, I don't see any immediate benefit to putting, like, doing the same trick with the tower that I wouldn't get otherwise, because I guess what I'm looking for is just a way to get it on top of my fork, and when it's on top of my fork, then put it on my head. But that's not the right way of thinking about this. There has to be a way of sliding the sausage out from underneath the this sausage, possibly using a half turn instead of a full turn, in such a way that this vertical sausage is already on top of my head. And in such a way that it's not resting on this tree. Because I can already think of a few ways in which I could do that, but they're not helpful. If I had another sausage that couldn't move, then I could use that as a similar obstacle. But that also presents its own issues, so really it's just good that I have just the single tile obstacle here. That helps cut down on the number of possibilities. I'm just trying to really think them out here. So these are the only half turns we've seen. The half turns are basically... Yeah, they're half turns in that they go to the diagonal tile to us, which pushes away from us in the orthogonal direction, like the same orthogonal direction. Like, our obstacle is to the south of us. The half turn also pushes southwards. And similarly for the other rotations, the obstacle is to the east of us, our half turn pushes east. So that seems to imply that, well, A, our fork is already in an empty spot. It's not stabbed into a sausage at this point. And because it's not a turn if you're stabbed. If you're stabbed, you strafe instead of turning. But it also implies that the sausage is in this spot and you push it to the east. So that means that the only way in which the sausage, like, the only way in which that creates a meaningful state change is if the vertical sausage is on top of the if like a support is removed in such a way, like it's already on top of the fork, and it's going to be better this way because of symmetry reasoning. So. Yeah, we've already seen ways in which we can remove the support, but still be holding it with a fork. So, if there's a vertical sausage on our head, then either we're standing right here and the vertical sausage is on our head facing either north or south, and in which case we're removing the other support out from underneath it anyhow, or in which case we'll be turning to face north, which is bad, or turning to face south, which is... also kind of bad. I'm envisioning, like, standing here, facing east. Vertical sausage is here, facing north. So it's both on my head and on the sausage, and I'm turning to face north. The problem is that since there's no tree, by definition, then I'm just going to be doing a full turn, and I'll be achieving the 0-degree position rather than either of the other two positions that I want, 90-degree offset or 180-degree offset. So if I want instead a tree offset, like to do this, then that implies that the sausage is either not on my head, because if it were on my head, it would be facing either north... which would mean it would be on the tree, the very tree that I'm running into, which is a problem. Or if it were facing south, then doing a northward move is irrelevant, because it's either moving a horizontal sausage, which is not supporting the vertical sausage, it's like all the way out here, and like, I've already got the position, what am I doing? Or the horizontal sausage is supporting the vertical sausage, and it's to the south of me, and not the north of me. So... I think that means this half-turn thing that I'm thinking about, this half-turn, I think that's a red herring. Because when I really reason it out like this, I don't actually see how it helps. Like, the best that I can do is get it on top of my fork. I don't see how it gets on top of my head immediately from there, which implies that there's some kind of terrain feature that gets it off of my fork and not on my head. I mean, gets it off my fork and onto my head. But the only way you can do that is with a wall that's on this particular altitude, and this is the only one that's relevant, and it's surrounded by floor at this height. If I had a two-tall tree, if this was a two-tall tree instead of a one-tall tree, I think I would actually be done already. Well, that's a huge statement to make. I don't think I would actually be done already, but I think it would help. I think it would help. Nevertheless, yeah, still not sure what I'm doing here. But it was fun messing around.